so lucky to have this Australian legend, Max Walker, on our couch all morning. We wanted to get a bit of insight about the man behind the mo. Max, you've achieved so much in your career. You've played for the VFL, you played, you know, test cricket. What's been the highlight for you? Commentating?
Oh, commentating has been a lot of fun. I really enjoyed radio. Alan McGilvray said, look, imagine you're speaking to a whole bunch of blind people if you can satisfy their needs in word pictures or painted words. Radio is different to telly. In Richie Beno's, you know, silence is golden. Sometimes you don't speak for four or five, I was going to say balls might be overs, no. But it, to me, along the way, it's been great from Hobart to here. You do a lot of things that the door just opens and you think, gosh, and, you know, writing.
When did the door open to cricket? Because by profession you're an architect.
Yes.
And I think your dad was a builder.
Yes, Big Max. He was a builder.
Big Max. Yeah. That's where you got it from. So how did you go from architecture to cricketer?
Well, it wasn't a conscious decision. It was like an evolution. Dad said, well, be all three, footballer, cricketer and build. So I did cross Bass Strait, studied at RMIT to do architecture. Footy became a reality with Norm Smith as my first coach, and then I got picked to play cricket for Australia. So whilst I practised architecture for about 10 years, and then I got headhunted to get involved in television and... But you don't consciously make these decisions. People said, why did you give up footy to play cricket? I just was in the West Indies in May and I couldn't play footy in Melbourne. And so I shelved that and I had a final year architecture thesis to complete at RMIT. And I did that. I just never got back to footy. Quit at the ripe old age of 22. And I just have a fascination for people and what makes them tick and businesses and that. That curiosity's...
Sorry to interrupt, Max. Everything you do, you seem to be very good at, whether it be footy or cricket or...
Architect,
or
author.
Or acting.
Or acting. Actor. God.
After losing 58 straight matches...
I'll extract that.
I've figured out there's something wrong with me glasses. These glasses.
The secret's in the elbow, actually.
Oh, he was dirty because he couldn't have a beer on a beer commercial at 6 a.m. in the morning. But that was fantastic. Well, you throw the dart into the fan and it ends up in the moose's head and it falls off the wall.
Comedy gold.
A lot of fun.
And my favourite, of course, is the AeroGuard one. This is an Australian modern classic.
Is it each day, Mr. Walker?
Sure is.
Don't the crowds annoy you, Mr. Walker?
No.
Anything at all bother you?
Yes, batsmen and flies.
That any good?
I reckon it works longer than the other, son.
Look at that, eh?
I used it too, Mr. Walker! Have a good weekend, Mr. Walker.
You too, son.
Do people yell that out to you? Because all morning I've been getting these tweets. It's hot out there, Mr. Walker. Do people yell it from their cars?
Well, look, still, we shot that commercial in 1977 and I was pretty raw. And the young fella in the commercial there, I think, had a lead role in I Can Jump Puddles on the ABC.
Yes.
And I think he's got probably a couple of kids of his own now. But, gee, that was a long, long time ago. And perhaps that commercial, you know, got me a chance to... perhaps beyond television.
And Maxie, when you see that commercial with your wonderful moustache, do you often yearn to grow it back down that way?
Oh, look, you wouldn't see it now. It's grey.
You can do anything with hair in the makeup room, Max.
We can touch it up. No worries. On the way. What about the hat too?
The hat is magnificent. But Merv Hughes, of course, took your spot in the field in front of Bay 13, and we all remember the whole thing.
Yes.
Was it part of the contract that he also had to take your moustache?
Look, my moustache pales by... If you were any self-respecting blowfly, you wouldn't go near Merv Hughes. I mean, those big branches, like, just hanging out just from under the nostril. You'd have to be really careful through, wouldn't you?
You could hang fruit off it.
But that's a massive moustache that the big fella's got, isn't it?
Big sideboard.
Yeah, it certainly is. Max, thank you so much for coming in today. Yeah. We've loved having you.
Thank you very much.